So I have re-inventoried the seedlings. The really struggling ones I put in here under the dome with their own little tiny fan to help strengthen them up. And then I put the more healthy, bigger ones towards the back. I am planting out 3 Chadwick cherries outside of the greenhouse in the square bed. I don't think we're gonna get any more frosts, but it's a bit of a risk, so I'm only planting 3. Pineapple, Pilsner Vessi, Amish paste. They were the ones that were ready to go. A lot of my ones out there, those are Chadwick cherries. They really took off and they really grew really, really fast compared to all the other seedlings. But these were my fastest growing of my beefsteak varieties. So they got to get transplanted out here, and I'm very confident I can keep the inside of the greenhouse above freezing. So fingers crossed there's not too much of a risk of putting them out here now.
6 Chadwick cherries in the square bed.
8 Chadwick cherries in the 12-foot bed. 1 sweet tang determinant in the barrel with the lavender. Starting to see the first new green buds on the plum tree. My strawberries appear to be a little confused. They're making flowers. It's February. Putting in some strawberry starts here on the south side of the 12-foot bed, along with some of the green onions that I have separated from the older clumps. I got 10 more starts of strawberries from a friend, pulled some more green onions from around, and have extended the strawberry patch. I have laid out compost in the middle along under the trellis. But yeah, this is where I'm gonna plant my tomato. I don't know if you can see her. Little ladybug on the underside of the leaf. The green onions are chugging along. This one's like 2 feet tall. Look at this monster. This is one snapdragon plant that I transplanted last year. And it is massive. It's showing like this one over here, you can see it's gotten damaged. It hasn't quite liked, it's gotten yellowed. It hasn't quite liked, you know, the freezing temps because snapdragons are not frost hardy, but this one is just so well established that it's already starting to flower again. So I'm really excited about keeping that there. I don't know if I do want to keep it there, but that plant, oh, it's so well established, it'd be such a shame to damage it by moving it. There's a bunch of carrots in here that are still chugging along, and and some of the old potatoes have started to sprout again too. Like in here, this is a potato. These are some radishes that sprouted from seeds in the compost that I filled this bag with. And I mean, I don't mind. I'll let them go as far as they're gonna go. The lavender is, it's already starting to flower again. Not quite sure if that, the geranium, just I think it's a geranium. I don't know how well it survived the frost. This year I didn't put it in the greenhouse at all to protect it, so it might be dead. Speaking of might be dead, this is the honeysuckle. And it was doing fine when it was freezing out, but now it's looking completely dead again. I have no idea where the growth cycle of this plant is in this zone. Jade plant's also looking like it took a bunch of damage, but it's still got some leaves, so I think it'll pull through. The garlic is coming good in over here. I transplanted some of these green onions over into the strawberry patch. This is a lavender and it's great, but I need to trim it because I don't want it taking over the entire pot. I still need to fill this bed and those 3 new beds with more soil. The rhubarb is insane. And like all of the stems are so perfectly red. It's gorgeous. And I have to look up how to actually like harvest and process that because that looks like a good harvest to me. The raspberries are starting to put off new buds. I can see that they're starting to put off new buds. But they never quite lost all of their old leaves. Again, I'm in a bit of a more warm climate than what this type is supposed to be in, so. Lavender over here, one plant's doing a whole lot better than the other. And I don't know what the discrepancy is, since I've been treating them the same, but this one bounced back from trimming a lot quicker than that one, so who knows. Garlic's going great. The garlic chives are exploding in the greenhouse. I don't know if the pepper plant survived at all. They were making flowers a little bit ago, but not flowers, more leaves. But now they're not, so I don't know. One of the raspberry transplants is really taking off, and I'm excited. I'm gonna plant that one out in that bed once I get the, you know, the soil in place for it. This will be where the peppers are going once the peppers are ready to be transplanted out. These are the daikon radishes, and they are starting to go to seed. So I don't think I'm actually gonna get much of a daikon harvest this year. I definitely think I needed to plant them in September and not later if I really wanted to get the most root production out of them. That's a note for next year. The garlic is doing great. Like, this garlic looks, starting over there, this garlic looks like just about as good as the garlic out there, and the garlic out there had a whole year to get rooted and established. So I'm really happy with how the garlic's turning out. I'm gonna harvest and dry all of the parsley that has sprouted in and amongst my bricks and like outside the boxes today before it gets too hot and they go to seed. This motherfucking squirrel is untying my trellis and stealing the string. Are you making a nest? Just a motherfucker.